terrestrial animals standing up to 20 feet tall. They're majestic and beautiful creatures, moving in what almost appears to be slow motion. But there's one giraffe at the Topeka Zoo that stands apart from the rest. Just 65 miles west of Kansas City sits the Topeka Zoo. Every year, thousands of people come to the zoo to visit their animals, and like many zoos, they have a particular animal that stands out. In the case of the Topeka Zoo, the animal that draws the most attention these days is a giraffe called Hope. When Hope was born 3 years ago, people didn't think she would live. Her condition was so bad, it required an entire team to help her survive. Hope received a second chance at life thanks to the effort of the zoo's staff. In a strange way, the staff received just as much from Hope.
It was a crazy birth. She gave birth in the middle of the afternoon, which is not typical. They usually give birth early morning hours. Hope's back legs were bent up in the forward position. So in a sense, she'd be almost trying to walk like if you were trying to walk on your wrist.
When a giraffe is born, within the first hour, they will cry and stand, and then very shortly after, they are walking and soon running. Wild animals must be able to do this, otherwise they become prey. With Hope, something was not right. Fortunately, Hope wasn't born in the wild because her legs looked like this. It's a condition known as hyperextended fetlocks, and it was serious. The zoo called veterinarian Dr. Joseph Kamer to the scene to analyze Hope's condition.
They were able to distract the mother so I could briefly go in and look at the baby. I was able to manipulate the feet from their horrible positioning into at least somewhat of a straight position.
Since this isn't something that Dr. Kamer sees on a daily basis, he did what veterinarians call a comparative study. He compared Hope's condition with cases from similar animals.
One of the main parts of the veterinary school is equine rotation. These types of limb abnormalities occur frequently in horses. I had to take what was done in the horse and figure out a way to get it on a cloven-hoofed animal who has two toes instead of one.
Within an hour of being born, Hope's legs were straightened and cast to remain in the correct position and to stretch out the contracted tendon in the front. When the casts were removed for the first time to check on Hope's progress, there was good news. The casts were working.
That's a great thing, but we got some cuts from the cast saw that we're going to fix. We had zero complications.
The casts were then reapplied to Hope's legs. They would have to be changed in 5 to 10 day intervals over the next 3 months. And each time, a virtual army of people were there to hold her down.
Everybody had their position and their part, and so we became very proficient at being able to do these procedures. Everybody knew what they had to do.
For the next step, Dr. Kamer attached extended heel shoes that he had made. Because a giraffe's feet are different from a horse, he could not nail them on. And since they could not be nailed on, Dr. Kamer decided it would be best to use cement. With each session, the staff bonded together to save this animal's life. As her legs grew stronger, the casts got smaller and smaller with each application. Eventually, they were able to remove the casts and shoes completely. And Hope started to walk normally. Now, when visitors stop by the enclosure, they can see Hope galloping around. Looking at Hope now, it's hard to believe she ever had a problem.
On this Sunday afternoon, middle of July, along comes a little giraffe that really, when she was born, we thought that there wasn't really any chance that she was going to make it.
Got her name from what she brought to the community, to the zoo, and to its staff.
If you can have Hope, you never have to underestimate what you can achieve. When you bring people together with passion, with emotion, and with an animal's best.